This is John Reed with QualityCoding.org. I'm in the middle of writing a blog post about TDDing some basic networking requests, and I've reached a point where I have two tests that I want to refactor. Let's look very quickly at their structure. I've got a mock NSURL session, which I pass into the system under test using constructor injection. And then I've got this request model, and I don't really care what its parameters are. I just need it so that the signature of the method I want to test is correct. And finally, there's a verification. So these two tests are very, very similar, except for the verification part. So let's start doing some refactoring. The first step is to run your test, because you should always start from a green state. So with that, Control T, let's extract an instance variable. I hit 7, and I don't want a leading underscore for IVARs in my test code. I do in production code, but not here. So there, it's pulled the mock session out as an IVAR, and let me copy what's left here and pull this into a setup. Now, AppCode has their own setup. If you do Control N to generate code, you can do this, but I don't like where it leaves me. I'd rather use my own with Control J, setup, and look at where it leaves the cursor. I like that better. You can get that template by subscribing to my blog. And now we no longer need that, and we no longer need that. Now we verify the refactoring by running tests with Control R in AppCode. In Xcode, of course, you use Control U. We're all green. Let's keep going. Let's extract the SUT using the same steps. Only this time, I want to set the SUT to nil in the teardown, and the reason I do that is to ensure that the lifecycle of the system under test is completely exercised in the context of tests, not in some weird state when the test infrastructure is disappearing on me and it no longer knows what test I'm in. So with that, Control R or Control U, depending on which IDE you're using. It's good. The tests are becoming simpler. Now we're down to the request model. As I said, I don't really care about these values, I just need one. Do I pull this into the test fixture? I would say no, because I know that right now these tests don't depend on the values in the request model, but very soon they will. I'm going to want to test the name prefix and the page size and the offset, that those all become valid parts of the URL. So let's do this. Let's extract this whole thing as a helper method. I'm going to call it dummy request model. And the reason I do that is so that the test expresses itself. Compare this test on top, where it's getting the dummy request model, and it's clearly the test doesn't depend upon the request model, just needs something, as opposed to the bottom, where the reader might say, well, what's this page size 10? What's this offset 30? Do those have special meaning? Nope, we do not want special meaning. Let's make that clear. Make your test code express what it wants. With that, Control R. I'm going to move this with a handy shortcut, Command Shift up arrow, just to pull that up a little bit and out of the way. There I've got now much cleaner tests that express what I want. Remember, refactoring applies to test code, not just to production code.